Dear students, welcome to online classes. I am Megasham. Today we are going to discuss about the lesson refraction of light at curved surfaces from 10th class physics. So in this module we are going to learn about the common terminology used for lenses. Check the picture and it is asking who am I. It is clearly cameras. But something is missing, they are only camera bodies. Yes, let us check this picture and they are also asking who am I. They are lenses. So what is the use of these lenses? We know very well that these are attached to the cameras. And check the numbers on the lenses. They are 24 mm, 250 mm, 300 mm, like that. Now the use is this one. Check the bottom picture. So about 300 mm. From that coming to 200 mm, 135, 105, see up to 18. Same location is pictured, taken, photo with different lenses, without zooming, without nothing. So these are the pictures of same location taken with different lenses. So how is this possible? What makes this difference with a simple transparent glass? We know lens is a transparent glass. So, but it is not just a simple flat glass. So these are all curved glasses. What is the meaning of curved glass? Let us check. Let us take a glass slab. Let us take a magnifying lens. Now check the surface of these glass slab and magnifying lens. So if you draw a line along the surface for the glass slab, it is a flat surface. For the magnifying lens, it is a curved surface. This is the difference with the flat surface glasses and curved surface lenses. Now, how many types of curved lenses are there? Yes, there are 6 types of curved lenses are there. They are, starting from the left, biconvex lens, plano convex lens, plano concave lens, concave lens, and plano concave lens, convexo concave lens, we call it as negative meniscus. And coming to our topic common terminology, we have 5 major terms to be discussed. They are optic center, centers of curvature, radii of curvature, principal axis, normal. For this, let us learn how lenses are prepared first. So first one, biconvex lens. In this chapter, we are only discuss about 2 types of lenses. They are biconvex lens and biconcave lens. Now, biconvex lens preparation. Let us take a glass slab and spot 2 points on the glass slab. Now, draw the circles by taking the points as the centers. So now we need to observe the intersection of these 2 circles on the glass slab and mark them. Yes, this highlight is the marked one. Now cut the glass slab along the marked path and take out the remaining. Now This is called as biconvex lens. In this way, convex lenses are prepared. Coming to these lenses, it has two surfaces. Check the dotted line. This is the surface 1. Check the second dotted line. This is surface 2. Coming to the convex lens, the midpoint, geometrical center of this curved lens is called as optic center. The center of the curved lens is called pole or optic center. It is denoted by P. Now, the first surface, surface 1, is a part of this sphere. Spheres contain the centers called as center of curvature and represented by C. So, but here the representation is done with C1 because this is the center of curvature of the first surface, surface 1. That's why 1 is the subscript added to the center of curvature C. Coming to the definition, the center of the sphere of which the curved surface is a part is called as the center of curvature. The distance between the center of curvature and the point on the curved surface is called radius of curvature, and it is represented with R1. Why? Because this radius of curvature is related to the first surface, surface 1. And coming to the second surface, it is also a part of a sphere. Again, it also contains the center, which we call is as center of curvature, but it is related to surface 2, hence the symbol is C2. And the distance between the center of curvature of the second surface to the point on the second surface is called radius of curvature, and the representation is R2. And the line passing through the centers of curvature and the pole is called principal axis. And the lines which are drawn along the radius are called the normals at the given point. Now, biconcave lens preparation. We have spotted points like this and drawn circles. Now, let us move away the circles little bit. Now, mark the shape. Yes, this is the shape. And cut along that marked one and take out the remainings. Now, the remaining thing is called concave lens, biconcave lens. And here, from the left side, surface 1 is on the left side and surface 2 is on the right side. This concave lens also have a midpoint called as pole. The two surfaces are nothing but the parts of the spheres, and they also contain centers of curvatures. Now, let you tell me which is C1 and which is C2. C1 is the center of curvature related to surface 1, and C2 is the center of curvature related to surface 2. Now, which is C1 and which is C2? Yes, we can easily tell that the left hand side circle has a center which has C1. Why? Because this is the center related to the first curve, and C2, another one is C2. And they are called R1 and R2, radii of curvature for the concave lens. And the axis passing through the centers of curvature and pole is called principal axis. And the lines drawn along the radius at a given point are called normal N. Now let us compare the concave lens and convex lens together and let us find some differences. So here in the convex lens, the center of curvature of first one means C1 and R1 are on the right hand side of the lens. And coming to the concave lens, the centers of curvature and radius C1 and R1 are on the left hand side, because these two are related to the first surface. And the terms related to the second surface for the convex lens is on left hand side, and for the concave lens are on the right hand side. Students, I hope you understood. Thank you.